Hello everyone. So today we are solving problem of the day of Geek for Geeks. Maximize the sum of selected numbers from an array to make it empty. This is a medium level rated question in Geek for Geeks. So in this question we are given n numbers. We need to maximize the sum of selected numbers. At each step we need to select a number a of I, delete one occurrence of a of I minus 1 if it exists, and a of I each from the array. We have to repeat this step until the array gets empty. We also have to maximize the sum of the selected numbers. So now understand the question briefly with an example. So here we have taken an unsorted array, and then we are in the brute force approach we have sorted the array so that in the descending order so that we can maximize the sum in our output. So in the first step we choose the element 15. And as we find the element that is 1 smaller than 15, so we remove both the elements and add 15 to the sum. Now in the next step, we head towards 6, and now we find that we don't have any number that is 1 less than 6. So we simply add 6 to our answer, and then we move to the next element that is 4. And similarly, we repeat the steps until we reach to 2, 2, 2 and 1. Here we find that 2 and 2 are two elements that are equal. So in this step, we add 2 to our answer and then move to the next 2. Then again we add 2 to our answer and then we move to the next 2. And here we find something that is 1 less than 2. So here we add 2 to our answer and then remove 2 and 1 both from our array. Now the final answer that we have achieved is 31. Now let's see the approach to our solution. So in the brute force we were sorting the array. But in the more optimal solution, we are using an unordered map. So in this unordered map, we are storing the frequency of the array elements. And now to find the maximum output, we are traversing in the descending order so that we can get the highest output. So now if we check whether the element has a frequency of greater than 0 or not. If the element has frequency greater than 0, then we will remove both the element. We will check whether the element that is 1 less than the current element is present or not. If the element is present, then we will add the element that we are currently at in the traversal to the sum. If it is not, then we will simply come out. We will repeat the step until the array gets empty, and now we will return the answer. Thank you.